every member of Her Majesty's household. People who, in all sorts of degrees, served her in different ways. As her procession passes, two of her staff lead the way. Her two pages, Paul Wybrew and Barry Midford. Paul Wybrew, we remember when the Queen was introduced to James Bond at the Olympics, and also Barry Midford, who was present when Paddington Bear had tea. No sovereign reigned from the headquarters of Buckingham Palace for longer than Elizabeth II. She takes leave and passes by the garden wall inside which so often she and her late husband, Prince Philip, King's Troop Royal Horse Artillery firing the minute gun as Big Ben joins in replying. And from the moment the Queen left Balmoral Castle those days ago, it seems the sun has shone on her journey, as it does passing under the trees here on Constitution Hill, towards her final point in this procession, Wellington Arch.
give you a hug.
Wellington Arch awaits the arrival of the late Queen. And to its left, at the base, wait the Royal Navy, who will be the piping party from His Majesty's Naval Base Portsmouth, Devonport, HMS Raleigh and HMS Iron Duke, who, when the time is right, will pipe the still. Just behind the massed armed forces, a modern building stands where 145 Piccadilly once was the home of the young Princess Elizabeth and her sister, Princess Margaret Rhodes. And they lived there with their parents, the Duke and Duchess of York. And it was from there that the princess's father went to become king in 1936. A change that altered her whole life. Procession finally leaving Constitution Hill and the great Commonwealth War Memorial with references to the nations who have helped to maintain peace from tyranny. that that session will halt. And the still will be sounded.
I'm not naked with you. I'm not naked with you. Stop us in the video. Yeah. ¿Qué es lo que voy a hacer?
¿Te van a cerrar la puerta?
Esto está en vivo.
Esa puerta está cierra también.
Eso no.
The sailor's job is done. They're hauled on the state gun carriage from Westminster Abbey to Wellington Arch, now completed. Her Majesty's coffin will be placed in the state hearse. Her journey to Windsor is about to begin.
Bueno. La reina Isabel ha fallecido y está transmitiendo en directo. Que sí. Que la televisión está transmitiendo en directo y
members of the royal family now gather together in order to witness this moment when the piping party call attention to the side. And the bearer party and the bodyguards march on. Bearer party. party will move themselves to the rear of this procession. For the Prince and Princess of Wales to have their eldest two children, Prince George and Princess Charlotte, watching, as the bodyguards who've looked after the Queen on this journey step aside. The bearer party from the Queen's Company, 1st Battalion Grenadier Guards, marching in to take up the Sovereign, who was their company commander. And the Queen's former equerries, who've acted as pallbearers and will do so also at Windsor, currently moving into position close to the royal family. Piping party saluting the side to give the Navy's final salute as 142 ratings pull away with the state gun carriage, leaving the bearer party ready to place Elizabeth II in the state hearse.
Bueno, tú vas a ir todo el día, yo me voy para ahí.
Yo voy a grabar, luego te doy la parte. Media del aire hay que poner para eso en blanco porque esto le va a apretar.
¿Has llevado tu moto? ¿Quieres llevar la fruta naranja? ¿Cómo no?
Saca la tablet ya. Tú no lo estás controlando, mira, yo que estoy
tan. Lo siento, me está mirando.
Quítale ya.
Ya, ya, sácalo.
With a final royal salute to Elizabeth II. The state hearse will draw her away from her capital city and start her journey to Windsor Castle. Royal cars will come forward. Members of the royal family will join them as a sister salutes her brother there. It will be for the Princess Royal and her husband, Admiral Sir Tim Lawrence, to once again escort the Queen on her journey. And Sergeant Major steps out of the way. And to Elizabeth II. A royal salute and farewell from London.
The national anthem is played as the bells of Westminster Abbey are rung fully muffled. This will live long in the memory. Children, grandchildren and great-grandchildren of the Queen watching her coffin gently placed in the state hearse. Princess Charlotte, a seven-year-old child, trying to absorb this day. She gazed out of the window as she was driven through London at the people, their patience paid off, the parade before them something not seen in generations. Past the cenotaph, site of remembrance, across the gravel of Horse Guards Parade, and past the office, Buckingham Palace. Those people, that crowd, now applaud their queen.
Bueno, ahí se lo están llevando la reina Isabel en el coche han cargado y bueno, están todos tristes con toda la seguridad ahí se lo llevan ya y la gente ahí está despidiéndose, público y bueno. Ha sido un día muy, muy triste, muy difícil de entender, es que la vida es así. No, es muy triste, todos llegamos a fallecer algún día, pero bueno, así está Inglaterra. Bueno, en casa grabando, está la, por la televisión, porque como es un día festivo, pues la gente está en sus casas. Esto está pasando en London, en capital. Pero claro, mucha gente no ha podido estar allá porque es muy lejos. De los Manchester, Liverpool, Leeds, de Escocia, todos esos lados, pues están observando. Bueno, le vamos a recordar siempre su reinado. Reina Isabel ha fallecido, ¿no? A los 96 años, 70 años ha sido reina de Inglaterra. Una gran historia tiene. Una gran historia tiene. Bueno. Ahí se lo está. La gente está recibiendo, aplaudiendo.
Lord Lieutenants were invited to the funeral, including Peaches Golding, Lord Lieutenant of Bristol. An extraordinary experience for everyone there and watching that.
It really was, and there were people from all around the United Kingdom. I ran into so many people that had come from long distances just to be able to pay their last respects to Her Late Majesty for all of the service, for all of her commitment, for the family of nations, the Commonwealth, the world. She was absolutely incredible, and everyone that could get to London wanted to be here.
And the draw, as you say, of royal families from around the world, heads of state, leaders of the realms too. It is hard to imagine anybody else who would bring such a congregation together.
And it's such a contrast between the Queen's platinum.